Photodiode is a device used to convert light energy into electrical energy. So we are studying the IV characteristics of a photodiode and hence the determination of responsivity of a photodiode. Here is the circuit. Look here. This is the circuit with which we are going to operate it, and this is the LED which we are connected. Once we have taken the reading, we are going to plot a graph of potential versus current in the third quadrant, which will be as shown. Here, this is the responsivity graph. We have to plot it like this. It is going to get a straight line. Look at the circuit of the photodiode, which will be printed on this board. Here, we have to connect according to the sign convention. So, we have to select the red wires to be connected to the red wire. Red points and black to black. So this is called potentiometer. Potentiometer has to be connected. Red to red I have connected. Similarly, I am going to connect black to black. And here is a gap of voltmeter. I am going to take two wires of one red and one black and connect it to the gap of red as well as black. Similarly, here is a current meter. Again, I am going to connect red to red as well as black to black. Then this has to be connected between these two points only because here is the sign convention point. Next, here selected a red one. You have to connect here. Again, you have to connect a black one. Here you can see this one. Output for light source. Here is a light source. Therefore, select this one and reverse it, red to red as well as black to black, you have to connect it. Similarly, the last connection is photodiode, connect red to red here as well as black to black here, and this is your photodiode. Again, you have to reverse it for the connection black to black as well as red to red. Since the wire separation is given, it will be very easy to make the connection. Now the circuit connection is built up. Now let us start the experiment. Okay, so here is the power supply. Please switch it on. Now you can see it is switched on. See here the photodiode as well as this what is called LED source are kept very close by. So look here. Here is the completely what is called by name power variation terminal. Here is the voltage variation terminal. Now I am going to adjust the power of an LED to 10 milliwatt. Correspondingly, I have to vary the voltage and corresponding current has to be plotted. Now look here, I am going to set it for completely 0.1. So 0.2 as well as 0.3 as it is shown by this. See, look at this. This is 0.30. And the current corresponding to this one is 0.25 milliampere. Suppose if I vary the current to 0.5, then your corresponding current, we are going to get it here, that will be completely shown in the tabular column. Like this, starting from 0.1 till 10 volt, it has to be varied in steps of whatever values given in the tabular column. Second part. Look here, I have told you the variation. See, minus 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, 0.4, 0.5, like this up to 10 volt here, and the corresponding current here. So power of an LED is 10 milliwatt, second trial is 20, third trial is 30 milliwatt. As I told you, the current should be copied along this line. Okay, this is called first part of the experiment. Let us move on to the second part of an experiment. In the second part of the experiment, so here you have to keep certainly the voltage to 5 volt. Voltage to 5 volt. Then we have to vary the volt, what is called power knob, in steps of 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60. Look here, let us start the second part. So by keeping voltage 5 volt constant, vary the power of an LED and copy the current of an LED. Now this is corresponding to the 10 milliwatt, corresponding current is 0.88 milliampere. let me increase this to 20 and the corresponding current will be 1.42. Like this, you have to vary this power knob starting from 10 till 60, and exact current values should be copied into the tabular column. Look here, this is the tabular column. Whatever I told, you have to enter the reading 10. So 10 watt corresponding current, 20 corresponding current. Like this, starting from 10 to 60, you are increasing the power and corresponding currents has to be plotted. Now we have the entire set of readings. Look here, this is in the third quadrant, similar to that of a transistor. In the first quadrant you are plotting that one. Here we are plotting in the third quadrant. Voltage along x-axis, current along negative y-axis. If you select a suitable scale and if you plot it, certainly here also we are going to get a straight lines only. Power of an LED 10, 20 as well as 30, you are going to get very easily. Similarly, we are having the values for the responsivity. Look here, IPD should be taken the positive y-axis, as well as the power of an LED should be taken along x-axis. If you plot a graph, 100% you are going to get what is called by name straight line. Just if you calculate the slope of this one, that itself is the responsivity. That means variation of current with respect to the corresponding power gives what is called responsivity of a LED as well as photodiode.